Hello, learners. So in this video, we are going to discuss an important topic, that is cyclotron. First, we should understand that cyclotron is the application of a moving charge in a magnetic field. Okay, whenever a charge enters in magnetic field, actually it deviates from its path and acquires a circular form and starts a circular motion, a helical motion. So on the same principle, this cyclotron is being designed. Actually, cyclotron is a particle accelerator. Most of the time, particle accelerator are used to accelerate any elementary particles like protons, electrons, neutrons, positrons. There are different type of particle accelerator available. And there are definite, and for every particle, there is a definite technique for accelerating a particle. For example, if we try to accelerate electron, then we can apply constantly increasing electropositive field and basically make an electron gun. And by calibrating that speed by using grid combinations, we can accelerate electron. So that is also some type of particle accelerator. But here we are discussing a very unique particle acceleration system, that is cyclotron. Actually, it consists of two D's, basically, which is placed between two heavy pole pieces, that is North Pole and South Pole, for that creating the magnetic field passing through these D. Within this D, these D's are connected with a high frequency oscillator. And when any charged particle is enters through the D, due to presence of magnetic field, it starts helical motion, a circular motion. And by applying these oscillation, high frequency oscillation, basically we try to match up the frequency. We try to maintain the resonance condition under which the external frequency must be equal to the internal one. So in that case, the charged particle is at its maximum speed, and then when we get the particular speed, we take the exit of that charged particle from this window. So this is all about the procedure of cyclotron. We will discuss how it has happened. This is the window available over here, which is also shown in this diagram. So imagining D1 is positive and D2 is negative, the positively charged particle kept at the center, and then the gap between the D's get accelerated towards D2. So due to particular magnetic field and according to Fleming's left hand rule, the charges get deflected and describe a semicircular path. Basically, cyclotron is a device which used to accelerate only for positive particles. Okay, this is not for electron, this is not for neutron. This is applicable for positive charge, basically proton-like charges. So when it is about to leave D2 becomes positive and D1 becomes negative, so it suddenly attracts towards D1. And on the other hand, when D1 becomes positive and D2 becomes negative, it's again increase its velocity and rush towards the D2. The same process will happening each and every time, so it can describe this just a semicircular path. The process continues till the charge traverses through the whole space within the D's, and finally it comes out with a high speed through the window. So when the magnetic force experienced by the charge provided its centripetal force required to describe the circular path. So basically that Lorentz force is balanced by the centripetal force. So as we know that centripetal force is mv square by r, must be governed by the Lorentz force qvb sine theta, that is sine 90 in this cyclotron case. Q is the charge of particle, v is the velocity, and capital V is representing the strength of magnetic field. So velocity here, from here the velocity can be deduced bqr by m. If t is the time taken by the charge to describe the semicircular path inside the d, then time taken is pi r by v, or time is pi m by bq. Time taken inside the D's depend only on the magnetic field and m by q ratio, and not on the speed of charge or the radius of the path. So if capital T is the time period of the high frequency oscillator, then the resonance is must be maintained when t is actually two times of small t. So that is total time period is capital T equals to 2 pi m by bq. So if f is the frequency of the high frequency oscillator, so f is actually 1 by time period, so bq by 2 pi m. For calculating the energy, we just try to make this particular equation by use this equation. For maximum energy, it is actually half mv square. So on using that kinetic energy, we get half m bqr by m square, that is half b square q square r square by m. So maximum kinetic energy of a charged particle is when r is actually equal to capital R, that is radius of d. Then maximum kinetic energy can be turned into half b square q square r square by m, where capital R is the radius of d. So the expression of time period and cyclotron frequency only when mass m remains constant, and other quantities are already constants, but m varies with velocity according to Einstein's relativistic principle, that is m equals to m naught by 1 minus v square by c squares power 1 by 2. Basically, this is relativistic mass correction formula, where m is the instantaneous mass and m naught is the rest mass. If frequency is varied in synchronization with the variation of mass of the charged particle to have resonance, then the cyclotron is called synchrotron, or a cyclotron, which is synchrome cyclotron. If magnetic field is varied in synchronization with the variation of mass, the charged particle to have resonance, then cyclotron is called isochronous cyclotron. So cyclotron can be used for accelerating neutral particles also, but electron cannot be accelerated because they gain speed very quickly due to their lighter mass and go out of phase with the alternating EMF and get loss within the D's. So basically we can accelerate the neutral particles also, but that neutral particles then synchronization by the variation of mass only, okay? So, but at that time, that type of cyclotron is known as isochronous. So this is the topic related to cyclotron. We are concluding this video here. If you have any problem, any questions regarding this topic, you can write the comments. I'll try to sort out those queries in our next video. Till then, thank you. Thank you, learners.